Hello there everyone, this is Iron Mark 3 and welcome back to my patchwork base in the Ashes of Empire campaign. What I've got planned for you today is mostly a building episode because, well, in the comments after the last video you guys suggested that I build a better anti-aircraft tank because quite frankly the MBTs aren't that good at it. So yeah, that is a thing. But I also need to get some kind of fuel refinery slash carrying vehicle which can help out with, you know, giving my tank some kind of range. Because as soon as they get into a fight, they drain their fuel at an alarming rate. So it's not exactly great. By 3, 4, 8, 12. Sure, like that. Yep. Now then, for this I'm going to go against, I'm going to go slightly against the conventions I've been using so far, which is build the vehicle, let you guys name it, because what I'm working on right now, with 15, that's what I'm after, what I'm working on right now is actually something based on one of the comments as well, like I should build an AA tank called the Scorpion, and I was thinking, yeah, that's a good idea. I want something with a single decent weapon which could be good against light flyers and things, as a light support type vehicle. And then the comment went, then my thoughts went, oh hey, what about the good old Scorpion from, Command and Conquer 3? Maybe I can do something with that. Or at least something loosely based on that. Is that the right way around? Yes, it is. So like that. Flip it around like this. So yep, so that's doubled up. Okay. And then gets four at the back like that. Yep, that's good. And then I just want some turning wheels to make sure it can actually turn properly, which would be nice. There. So I'm afraid I preemptively called this one the Scorpion, because of my overall plans for the style of it. So yeah, sorry about that. But that's why I'm giving it this basic triangle shaped frame, just to start out. So I'm doing it like this, yes. Something else I'm going to be doing as well, I think, is I'm not going to have these, whoops, stupid, like that, yeah. I'm not going to have the rounded out blocks around the treads underneath like I did on the Scarab MBTs. I mean, oops. Actually, yeah, let's have it this way around. I'm not going to do that because, quite simply, that is a constant source of damage for the Scarabs. Whenever they hit slopes and things, those low down blocks, even though they're sloped, are catching on the actual terrain and breaking off. So the Scarabs are slowly damaging themselves over time. It's not that great, to be quite honest. Just move this forward a bit, like so, yep. Like that. Beam 3, beam 2, yep. So, I'm going to have those wheels lower down a little bit more exposed, but that should mean they won't damage themselves quite as much. At least, that's the theory. If it's going to work out that way, that remains to be seen. Actually, I should pull those sides off, yeah. Yeah, like that. Now then, since this is going to be called Ye Holy Scarab and things like that, how am I going to work on this? What is it going to have? I want something that's going to be good against aircraft. And then I thought, this could be fun as well. Let's go ahead and work my magic with lasers, because you guys have never seen me work on a laser before, have you? Well, I'm going to try. I'm going to make a small laser for you guys. A very small laser. And that means I want to have the main block over here. Yep. Because I need to have space to turn it around, and then need space for the armor outside that as well. So, lasers. Normally they are really big, really powerful things. Great beasties of a weapon system. And they need to be, because they need a big laser to have a lot of punching power, to have the sheer piercing which laser weapons are known for, It's all the Q switches, because if you have a load of Q switches, it's much faster firing, and it's also, yeah, it's much faster firing, it's more likely to hit something. It's a single Q switch extends the range greatly, but after the first one, they decrease the damage, but they increase the efficiency by a huge amount. So if you want to get the most damage out of your raw power, you need to have lasers. And then that's, no, that's not worth it. Four, one, two, three, four. Yeah, that's probably a bit too many. Okay, sure. So yeah, I'm going to include a small light laser system in place of a cannon, and that is going to be the main damage dealer. Just a pure laser system. And of course, because it's a laser, it needs to have a source of power, which is where this is going to come in. Now, a small laser system, mirror mode. A small laser system, you can't really go for a piercing setup because it will do absolutely nothing for damage. And you can't really go for a damage stabilized setup because that will cause problems in and of itself. So let's see, how am I setting this up? Should I do it like this? Do I want 3 per engine or 4? Let's go for 3 per engine, sure. There we go. So, a small laser system, you need to rely on sheer engine power to sustain its damage output. If your laser doesn't have the engine power, it will fail as its pulses rapidly deplete its internal storage. And the other thing is, the cavities can't actually hold enough if you have a whole load of... let's get some injectors in here. Yep. If you have a whole load of... pumps and things going on, but no large cavities to hold the energy, then your engine is going to struggle just to maintain its energy levels. So, yeah, it's not ideal at all, but you can make a decent enough weapon that can punch through a single block of metal with a single hit, and something like that can shred a small craft really quickly. But you need to have a single storage cavity so it can actually build up that much, because I went into the testing mode to make sure I was completely familiar and the lasers hadn't changed much since last time I used them, because, let's be honest, it's been ages since I last used an engine. Sorry, an engine? I use engines all the time, since I last used a laser. Like that, yep, so just exhaust them straight out of the hull to help try and cool them down a little bit. Yep. These things are going to be horribly efficient. Horribly efficient. Efficiency is a dream for these engines, but I need the raw power, so it sucks to be them. And that means I need resource, I need fuel. Fuel storage, fuel beams. Yeah. Yeah. This thing's going to have a lot more fuel storage than the MBTs, but it really needs it. It really does. Okay, that's gives it 2,000 horsepower with those two engines. They will not cool themselves properly. I must point that out, they will not cool themselves properly. They've only got two exhausts. But that is how it's going to have to be. But if I add one more loadout... Sorry, two more like this. Like that, yep. Like that. Sure, like that. Yeah. These things will not cool themselves properly at all. They actually need additional additional cooling from radiators, which is going to do wonders for the efficiency even more. But that's sadly the way it has to be. Like that, yep. And then I need another exhaust. Corner pipe it. So yeah, this is basically going to be a really fast pulse laser, which can do enough damage per hit to knock out, say, a regular metal block. It won't punch, they don't have any armor piercing, but it doesn't need it because it just won't do enough damage. Junction pipe, no, I need a throughput pipe like that, yeah. And then a hull exhaust, like that. Okay, yeah, that's fine. It just won't work. Just won't work at all. Do that, yep. Blocks metal beam by 3. There we go. Okay, that's the hole filled in. All exhausts are... Oops, no, that's not connected at all. I still need a little bit more power. So, carburetor. I must confess, I tested something somewhat similar to this, trying to work out exactly how I needed to do it. Because that was part of how I was trying to work out, am I remembering all this right, or am I going to be a complete and utter idiot and just, well, there's an idiot move right there. I've accidentally added something to my toolbar list, and I'm not entirely sure how to remove them, so go me. But I wanted to make sure that I have my laser theory correct before I started working on this idea. See if I could actually do it. And lasers haven't changed that much since last time I used them, so, you know. Yeah, yeah. That looks okay. Sure. Now then, let's add the most important part to this. The laser chargers. Because there's no point having a laser without a charger. Storage capacity, pumps. So yeah. I'm planning to use about 2,500 in terms of raw recharge on this laser. Well, that was a bit of a noise, wasn't it? That's 600, 1,200, 1,800, 2,000. Engine's really starting to rev up. 2,200, 2,300. Sure, let's put some more in there. And that will use 2,500 power just to rev up the laser. Let's actually yank it out just to make sure. Yep, 2,500 to rev up the laser. And that, without any damage or anything like that, will maintain a pulse damage of roughly 300. My target is 280, so that should be just fine. Laser connectors, sure. Actually, let's pull out that fuel tank there. And what I need is a laser transceiver to route the power. It's gonna have to be down there or under the tank. I think it's gonna have to be here, actually. Yeah. I'll get back to you as soon as I've got a proper thing working, because I've realised I've spent about half of this video just talking about what I'm trying to do here, and not skipped. Part of that is because I am actually short on time for this video, and I want to get two vehicles done. The first being this one, and the second being, you know, some kind of fuel carrier. So, yeah, I'll see you in a few moments. Okay, we're getting somewhere. We have the core of the new vehicle. We've got the laser system just embedded in there. It's nice and happy, though I can actually do a slight improvement on this. Let's lasers, cavities. Since they've only got a single injector there, sorry, a pump, let's install a single input cavity, which will increase the storage slightly. Won't matter that much, really, but, you know, there we go. The engine needs exhausts. No, not exhausts. What am I on about? The engine needs some radiators to help maintain its power reserve. So that's going to be like this. Da, da, da. I've connected up the exhausts. Everything like that. Actually, can a adapter use a large radiator? That is a question. No, it cannot. Okay, that's fine. That radiator bank there will have to do. And that is my engine. I've added some more fuel storage to it, because it really does run through fuel quite quickly, and this is probably just overkill as far as fuel is concerned. But I want to make sure this thing doesn't run dry in a fight. And up here is the core of the laser cannon. I know, it's such a diddy little thing, isn't it? And it's also floating in midair, because I've done... You guys haven't seen this one from me before, really, either, have you? I'm using a two-axis turret for this thing. So that means I've installed a light block underneath, Then there's the turret, then there's the transceiver connecting to the laser system down there. And then it's just connected straight into a combiner, and there we go. And of course it's got onboard local weapon control, wireless, and an IR camera for helping on accuracy. It's not going to do a thing for the range, really, because its range inaccuracy is like 12% or so, but this thing doesn't really care much about range. It's a laser. And then there's no steering optics at all in this beam. That's because the turret is going to do all of the steering for it. Can I get close enough to actually use this thing? Not really. Okay, let's get a fire control on here. Just so you can see. Actually, let's just install a fire control period, because I need to install a seat anyway. Right. Now, this is a really light turret, but because of that, really, really fast, like that. So yeah, it doesn't really care too much about things like turning time. Then if I fire it, there we go. Laser sustaining, engines draining, fuel dropping pretty darn quick, but the laser is keeping up its pulses as well. Let's see, how's the laser holding up? Where's your laser data? Here we go. No, that's not it. Yeah, it's maintaining nearly 400 odd damage at a range of 10 kilometers, and its inaccuracy is 0.05, which is high for a laser, but it's definitely going to do the job. So yeah, that's what this craft can sustain. Though that said, I could probably do with reducing it. Yeah. Let's actually take off a couple of the injectors, because it's not quite where I want it to be. Let's take that one off and take that one off. Okay, because I want to have a little bit more fuel, sorry, a little bit more power left on this tank, just to keep it, you know, I want to have a defensive shield and I want the engines to keep running, you know. Engines? Yeah, the engines, like as in the tracks and things. Okay, let's get some control on here. Be a controller, ship wheel, like that. Yep. Actually, let's put that to one side. Yeah, like that. This is going to be slightly lopsided at the back, but yeah, I've got the that is the basic of the laser system. It's fast tracking, pretty accurate, really long range, hits hard enough to knock out most small blocks in a single strike. Bigger blocks will take several, but it fires incredibly quickly, so that is going to be the basis of this new anti-airstroke, anti-light vehicle tank. So yeah, I don't think I'm going to have time to build a fuel carrier, so that's going to have to wait for the next video, unfortunately. I just hope that this thing proves interesting to you as my support vehicle. Now, it's time for the hull and the AI system. And then this thing will actually be complete. So here we go. Well, I was hoping this wouldn't happen really, but it seems that the white flares are now poking me straight back with a beholder. Was that what attacked me before? Might have been. It's going after my prototypes though, so it's going to be a slight problem. I'm going to bring in my main fleet as well, so I've got all my tanks against this thing. And I have to try and not get nuked into oblivion like I did before. That would be nice. Yep, the enemy has got considerable mass on me, actually. I'm glad I decided not to try and push for the actual... In battle setup phase, you can only move forces around. That's what I'm trying to do, buddy. I'm trying to move it around. There we go. I'm trying to get these things down onto the flats, because that is what I need for the scarabs. On the hills, they aren't that great, because as I mentioned before, they will damage themselves over time, clipping into things. But I'm also only be able to spawn some of my units in at the start, so there is that as well. Okay, beholder, let's see what you've got. Begin the... he outmasses me slightly, but I think I have enough tanks to compensate. Let's see what you've got, oh, white flares. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I didn't teleport and let the terrain spawn in. Oh, wobble. come on. Okay. Lots of missiles. I don't have any anti-missile Well, that's one of the prototypes down already, thanks to missile impacts. Yeah, just untethering my camera so I can do that.
Yes? Resuming control.
Yeah, because you guys do need to move.
Yes?
And you're trying to punch into this thing. And it's got shields! The Beholder's got shields. It's got an advanced cannon of some sort as well, but the shields are actually worrying me. Oh, and it's got a railgun. Well, that's bad news, isn't it? Yeah, I'm assuming direct control. Let's get into this thing. Stop wasting your ammo, please. Thank you. Yeah, this is what I meant, you see. It's shredding the undersides of its tracks as it moves in. And that's getting in the way of it as well, which is not helping. Do I actually have a line of sight now? I think I do. Yeah, I do. No, not quite. No. Come on, stop breaking yourself, you silly little tank. You know, I didn't think this was possible, but this prototype has actually managed to beach itself. It can't move. Oh wait, no, it's just that it ran out of fuel, I think. Nope, nope, it's genuinely beached itself. Okay. You need to keep firing at... there. No, it can't even get into place. Fine. Right. That's both the prototypes actually out of the fight. That one's slightly damaged, the other one actually got itself killed, I think. So up to this one. Yeah, this is the one that's beached itself. That one is actually out of the fight, which leaves just this single MBT actually trying to take on the opponent. Yeah, this is going swimmingly, actually. Let's hop outside and see if I can just get the hell. Oopsie daisy. Note to self, the scarabs are actually pretty bad in hilly terrain, and when the fuel runs out, that's it. They can't do a thing. Well, they can't maneuver. Though that said, the Beholder it doesn't seem to have to do much either. That said, though, my shells are doing some damage. I think the Beholder's... Yeah, it's just sitting there trying to kill me. Can it do a thing against this, though? We are about to find out. Oh, I think it's flouting as bad as I am. Yeah, yeah, it's beached itself as well. Oh, dear. Well, time for a boarding action. I have no idea where the controls might be. But reaching through the room... Wait. That radar's behind glass. Does that actually work? I'm gonna have to try that later. Come on, let me in. Let me in. I'm inside! Woo! Right. Now, where's the AI of this thing? Wait, this is the control seat. Ah, down here. Right, okay. Oh, that's fuel. Leave that alone. A chapel? Yep, that fits, definitely. This thing is really well built. And I believe I see... No, that's resource. That's the AI. There it is. Is it the only AI, though? That's the question. Wait, that was a wireless receiver, wasn't it? primary engine, more wireless receivers. Oops, I'm clipping through something. Oh dear. No, I don't want to be outside again. Darn you. I need to go back into the front door. Ah, I think I found it. I think that's it over there. Right next to all that fuel, so... Odds are this is going to touch off a really big explosion. I don't want to be sitting right here, but I've got to be to actually shoot at the thing. Down there, yeah, come on. Do I have control? No. How far have we got? Not far enough. Okay. AI destroyed, I think. Is that the AI? Yep. And I didn't touch off the fuels. I almost did, but not quite. Now, how do I get out of here? Nah, here we go. Unfortunately, the vehicle is not mine, so that means there's another AI in here somewhere. Oh, I see. There is actually an access hatch up on top. Right, okay. Well, the best place I think for the AI would actually be back here somewhere, because that cannon's still firing, so it's got access to an AI. This is looking quite dangerous, actually, but I do like the style, I must admit. Oop, nope, clicking through the hole again. Oh, jeez. I was hoping to avoid this, but this is eating up too much time. I don't have the time left, really, to properly find the AI, which sucks. So I'm going to have to start randomly destroying stuff. Actually, where's my grenade? Grenade. Here we go. Grenade. Detonate the fuel. Let's see. Because I need to find and kill the AI. And I have no idea where it is at all. So the only solution, reasonably, is explosions. Yeah. Oh, hello! I was just starting to take out the ceiling, and there's a surge protector up there, and... Hello, are you an AI? Oh, yes you are! Okay, one! Woo! And I've got one really big thing in salvage. A really big damage thing. But yeah, this is... That took much longer than I actually had, so yes. I've caught it, and it's that's a huge catch. Oh, wow. Okay, pull everything back out. The tanks did okay, though they did get a bit battered. The Beholder can come back up to base because it needs to be checked out.
On my way.
But now I really, really, really need to get the Scorpion finished because... If I don't do it now, I'm not going to have time. Quite simply, because I've got to get to work. So, let's get to it. There we go. Scorpion. Yeah. Let's finish this thing up. Well, I was afraid of this when I came under attack from the White Flayers, but I didn't have time to manage what I was trying to do. So sadly, I have been away to work. I've come back from work. This is when I wanted to be uploading this video, not actually capturing the final part and then going about rendering it. So, hooray. You are going to get this video today, but it's going to tie up my computer for the rest of it. So, whatever. Okay, what have I done? I've finished it. I've finished the Scorpion, practically. It's now the Scorpion AAT, short for Anti-Aircraft Tank. It's got this cramped cockpit short control area, so it's got some manual control if possible. It's also got the full AI and all of the processing cards in here. It's got ACBs as a provision for shield control. Though that said, it doesn't currently have a shield projector because I couldn't decide where to put it, so it can sustain a smaller shield, but where it'll go, I don't know. And of course, there's a lot of radiators up here because the engine needs the cooling, to be quite honest. Speaking of the engine, I actually expanded that as well. So the engine is now 20% larger. It was 5, now it's 6. I've also improved the cooling on that as well with extra carburetor and things just to keep it relatively efficient, so it can do better now, at least. But this is what I've come up with, the Scorpion A80. Based loosely on the design of the Scorpions from Kane's Wrath and Command & Conquer 3. It's got a very rounded front, then a central section towards the back. Admittedly, the front section is much smaller than it was in the Command & Conquer version, but this one needs to be bulky because it's got to house the engine and the power plant to actually allow this thing to function. And then on the back, we've got this turret with twin pinch-like sections and the main stinger, which is, of course, the laser cannon. And I finally yielded and I gave it a single steering optic, so it's got a slight bit of leeway from the aiming, but it's mostly just the same, and it's got the same inaccuracy profile and all the rest of it compared to how it was when I was working it out. Now it's also got full detection, and it's got the anti-missile system as well, so it can actually shoot down incoming missiles pretty reliably. Let's see, under the hood, this thing actually has up to 13,000 fuel storage, which is pretty high. It can also hold 9,000 resources, so it's a bit of a pack rat as well, in terms of carrying excess resources around. So it can actually hold a fair bit more than the Scorpion MBT, but speaking of the Scarab, though, it actually costs roughly the same, 9,600, so much for being a light anti-aircraft vehicle. It's actually a full-on tank, admittedly with a very different role and very different... Yeah, I'm going to have a look at that because I'm not sure what's exploding in my main base, but it just seems to keep happening every so often. But this thing is intended to deal with light targets and fast targets more than anything else. So it's got this laser. It's supposed to plug away at things until they break. It can vaporize most smaller blocks in a single hit or two. Because I've also amped the laser up a little bit as well. If I just come in here, I'll show you. It's still a single laser cavity, but I've increased the number of pumps up to roughly the limit of what the single cavity can sustain for laser power. So it can actually maintain full pulses at about 490 damage per shot, which is pretty powerful. Though its range does suffer a bit when it drops down. That's the main limitation of it. It gets shortish range if it's firing for a while, but it still hits pretty hard. And it hits instantly, and it's pretty accurate for such a small system, so that's what it does. How well it'll do, that remains to be seen, but that is what I've made of it, the Scorpion A80. Now, this is what I was trying to avoid, because I had a quick look earlier, and so I noticed that this attack was coming in, and I wanted to avoid it, but it's come while I've been blathering on, so no, I don't want to view that. Instead, I'm going to wrap it up and save that for the start of next time. What I've got is the Scorpion A80. I've named it myself already, but I've not picked a colour scheme. So you guys can pick a colour scheme. And now I really need to finish this and get it rendering so I can actually upload it today, because time is not on my side. So yeah, this has been Iron Mark 3. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show. That reminds me, I'm not sure what to do with that big vehicle I captured either. I mean, it's sitting over there. Any suggestions on that? Also welcome. Maybe I'd just break it down for scrap, but I could also try and fix it and see how that works. But yeah. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you some other time. See you later. Oh, jeez. That was another bad outro, wasn't it?